Today I'm going to help you make an order form for team merchandise like t-shirts using the Payable add-on for Google Forms. I've gone to payableapps.com and I'm going to use one of their templates to help me get started really fast. To start, I'm going to use this copy template button to copy the template to my own Google Drive. Now that I have the form in my own Google Drive, I can go in and make any modifications, such as adding my team name and deleting any of the stock text that we have in here. I can add other pictures and watch the videos that we've linked as well. You can see here I've got a couple of t-shirt samples and sort of different ways that we can format the questions to accept payments using this standard format that we use with our Payable add-on. So if I like all of these questions, we'll go through and we'll just make the form payable. So to do that, I'll go up to this three dots at the top and I'll go to Get Add-ons, and then I'll find the Payable Forms add-on just by searching in the Google Workplace Marketplace. So I can install Payable Forms, and then that Payable add-on will always be available at this puzzle piece at the top, and it will let me open up this sidebar. When I make the form payable, the sidebar pops up and will be available to edit things like the checkout and different settings that will help you collect payments. In the sidebar, you can see that there's these different settings that we can quickly click through to configure the form, sync our theme to the checkout, so that's to match some of the settings and the different photos we have, and then to connect our payment provider. I'm going to skip the add payment section, but that sample payment section is another way you could make your form quickly and get the right formatting versus using a template as I have in this example. I'll set up my payment provider now, which is simply just logging into Square, Stripe, or PayPal, or a few other different options using your existing account. Now that I have my account connected for payments, I can make the form payable. This will set it up in the testing mode. So it's for fake money right now. We're on for practice, whereas once we're ready to go, we can switch it over to real money. I'm gonna leave it on practice here while we're just setting up and testing out our form. There's a few settings here, and you can make sure that they all match what you expect as far as the type of currency you use. You can also change a few of these other settings, like adding shipping addresses or taxes or handling fees, custom checkout text that you'll add, so in different instructions in the checkout or on the post payment, which can be really useful. Maybe you have like a tax ID or just directions for people if they're coming to an event or something like that can be helpful. And then the one that I often will add is this payment reminder. So sometimes people will check out, they'll select all their t-shirts, they'll submit the form, but they might not finish the checkout, right? This is sort of an abandoned cart checkout. You don't want it for all of types of payments or forms, but a lot of times that's a nice thing to turn on under notifications here on the sidebar. And then of course you can also do promo codes if you were having you want to do discounts for certain people, like people on your team or volunteers or something. You could certainly do that very easily. So what I'll do now is I'll go up and I'll use the preview button so that I can fill out the form. And I'll do that here quickly and then we'll check out how things look after someone submits the form. Okay, so I made this one sort of complicated and I got a shirt and I ordered a hat and I put the shipping selection, and then I also used this handy donation option where it's sort of an open field and you just put this dollar figure at the end of the title for that. So let's see how this goes. So this is the submission or the confirmation page that you'd usually get in a Google form. You can see that the add-on has added this link that someone could click, and then it's going to calculate the checkout. Okay, so this is our cart or checkout, and again, it's in test mode, so this won't be here once we turn it on for real money. But you can see that complicated order that I made through our form, it's all there, all five items, tallies the amount. And then this is again sort of a test process you can go through. These are fake cards that you can use and enter and sort of see how the full checkout goes. But we won't do that today. What we'll do is we'll say, okay, we like that. It seems like it's working really well. We have all our pictures. So then all we do is we flip it over. It's for real money. And then I can go up and get this share link at the send, and I can start sending this to my clients or customers or sharing it on social media so that I can start getting these orders. Now, of course, once you start getting orders, the other thing is that then you're going to have this handy sheet where the orders are going to appear. And so that's again where you can sort of keep track of your customers and track all these orders. So again, that complicated order that I did with five different items, that's all here in my form. You can see this is my test email. So if I had any questions for this customer, I could get at them. And then if I had to actually go through and, put together this order and box it up and send it to them, I could send this to whoever was doing that, fulfilling the order, and they'd be able to figure that all out as far as the shipping address and then which items they're getting as well. So really nice that we can still use that Google Sheet, just based off of our Google form and the Payable add-on to sell our team merch.